like, you know, on the stream, like, oh, we'll be on in 10 minutes or something.
Oh.
But I don't know how to do that.
It's possible that would be kind of cool.
Did the information update on the. Ooh, are we live? We're live.
We have an advertisement playing.
Whee! Hello! Oh, I see Spooky Jay's here. What's up, Jay? Welcome to another Squishable Twitch. Squish. I'm Pat, and that's Sam.
Hello.
And we also have Adria over there. No one can see you. It's just me and my face. I'm a star. Is it someone, I have no way of knowing, so if my audio is an issue, someone just yell at me.
Sounds good so far. I just muted you, but you sound good in my headphones for a second.
Sam just muted me. Classic. Classic Sam. So how's everyone doing? How's your week been? We've been drawing up a storm at Squishy HQ. We're making way for a bunch of new releases this week, one of which being a big old Samoyed. So this is the tentatively titled Samoyed Stream. Bam! Also, I got my fancy live stream UI up and running, I think. Now you have a little border with Squishable Live on it instead of just Photoshop. I know it doesn't matter to anyone but me, but it matters to me. Considering last time I attempted that, Photoshop crashed 4 consecutive times. So, hopefully it does not do that again, but so far so good, right? Right? That's not how you spell right, but we're getting there. So yeah, we're just gonna hang out, draw some doggos, maybe draw some comics, maybe get to some prototypes. Who knows what the evening will bring? I don't. I certainly do not. Here, take a look at this hot dog while I make sure everything is running smoothly. This little hot doggo. I don't know, I've never actually encountered a Samoyed, but I've watched a lot of videos of them.
They're lovely.
They seem like lovely, lovely dogs.
My best friend had two.
Big and floofy.
Marshmallow and Snowball.
Oh, Marshmallow and Snowball. Those are the best dog names. Those are so good.
They were sisters.
Marshmallow is perhaps the most appropriate Samoyed name. Hello, squish me. hello, Prashant. Hey, Prashant. Jay, you're absolutely right. Cthulhu says crash Photoshop. No one is surprised, not anyone. And the man behind the iron door, I can absolutely draw some puppers. No worries there.
Lots of puppers.
Puppers and doggos. Excellent suggestion. We currently have a mini Samoyed plush, which is super cute, limited edition, and it is so flippin' cute, we decided that we need to make it really big, like a Samoyed would be. So, that's coming out this week. Bam, bloom, straight to the moon. I think Sam is trying to find one. Oh, Duchess, the Samoyed, that's so precious.
So this, let me show you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Okay, this is our limited edition mini that this guy was actually based on.
Oh, there he is.
There he is.
Oh, look at him, his feet.
He's got the big fluffy Samoyed tail.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll hang on to him since it's the Samoyed stream.
Put him in the back, too. The little one back here.
He's real big. Pay no attention to the man behind the Samoyed. So, yes, to commemorate? I don't know what the word is. To celebrate the Samoyed, we're going to do some comics. And also, drawing round squishy dogs is a lot of fun. So, who can complain? Not me, or you. Well, you could, but that'd be rude. It's good to get like a feel for whatever little squishy you're drawing, or if it's not squishy, before you actually do something serious. Because I always just go right for the final drawing. And then realize halfway through that it's bad and dumb. And the proportions are wrong, or it's not funny enough. So you do some like real bad, you got all the bad drawing out to start. Like, these feet are probably too big. I don't care. Big curly tail. Oof. So how have you guys been this week? We have lots of new things coming out this week, so I'm here to answer any questions as well as draw cute dogs for you. In particular, one surprising project that has taken the office by storm that we can get to later.
Yes, Jay just mentioned it.
yep, Jay, the minimals are now no longer just a joke. It's an April Fool's joke that's been given unholy life. I know, yeah, I'm as surprised as anyone.
I think we all are.
But it's happening!
You're on Wii Squish, so if you want them...
you can get one. Do we have one here, right?
We do.
We actually do have them.
It's not just all Photoshop trickery all the time. I'm going to put the link in the comments so that you guys can see what we are talking about.
Yeah, in case you're not totally entrenched in our April Fool's joke of the year. Or maybe you are.
Oh, yes. Actually, they're up here. Yes, thank you. That's exactly where they are.
The minimals. The modern aesthetic. The new plush for a new audience.
Black, white, and gray up right now for Wii Squish. There's enough interest, we'll consider doing other colors. I don't really know. We'll see what happens. But these are...
They're just orbs.
They're just balls of fur.
I mean, hey.
They're very soft.
We don't judge. They're very soft. You can squish them.
Mm-hmm.
You go, girl. Yeah, I feel like they're going to be very good for decorating if they do, in fact, hit the minimum required pre-orders. Be like, add that designy touch while still being very soft. Well, Alex, unfortunately, they're only in gray right now, but again, if there's enough interest, then who knows? Maybe there'll be a pink one.
Who knows?
I certainly don't. I was imagining him just howling, but he could, in fact, have a harmonica here. Now it's not invisible anymore. Samoyed's Dream. 2K17. Alright, why don't we... I'm just gonna ink one of these dogs. I'm gonna ink one of these doggos. And then maybe do a comic. What kind of brush to use of my million? This is the part of this room where you get to see all of my tool presets. No. Look at, why do I even have this? Why would I, under what circumstance would I use this brush? I don't know. It's just fancy. Out there, dog people. Sam is a dog person.
She's not a dog person.
Yeah, it's true. Who isn't a dog person? I don't know. Some people prefer cats. I prefer birds. Everyone has their thing. Although I shouldn't say that I prefer birds, because I've never had a dog.
Behind the iron doors commenting about your mom mug. Yes,
this is my mug. I got this for Christmas from my cousin. It says wow sometimes. Sometimes it says mom. Sometimes it says dad.
The three possibilities are
endless. Now it's a dad mug. Delivers sweet coffee to my face.
Squish Me is asking, how many full-time artists are there for Squishable?
How many full-time artists are there at Squishable?
Let's see. We have
a couple.
We have Pat and I.
That's at least two.
We have Rachel, who you have heard from previous streams. She is not only helping us out, but she is on a European adventure right now.
Yeah, she's not here. So, lame.
She's the lucky one right now, gallivanting about Europe. So she is a part-time artist for us. We have
the wonderful Adria.
The wonderful Adria.
That is sitting across from me.
Who is also here a few days a week helping... to Project Open Squish and managing all of that and helping us with prototypes. And then, of course, Zoe is kind of our creative officer of sorts, you know, one of the founders of Squishable, and she's technically on the art side too. So we have quite a few artists. We've
got a good smattering.
Yeah. We also have Jenna. Shout out to Jenna, too.
Shout out to Jenna.
Does some freelance work for us. She does some great little animations and comics and things.
Oh, yeah. I also love digital drawing. Alex is the only drawing for me because I'm not very good with a pencil. At least when it comes to making finished work, it stresses me out.
Don't you undercut yourself like that?
I need layers.
Yeah, there's something very validating about a control Z at any point.
Alex, this is Photoshop Creative Cloud, which is my go-to, which is a little bit expensive if you're just sort of starting out, but there are plenty of free or just like pay once programs. I used to use Manga Studio, which is now Clip Studio, and that is, you can get a really like discounted version of it, and it has a fabulous drawing software. And also, Autodesk Sketchbook is a good option for just like sort of sketching. It's less good for finished work, but a lot of people use it for start to finish. It's just sort of whatever you learn, whatever you spend the most time in. I happen to spend the most time in Photoshop, so I have all these tool presets, boop, like 100 million billion, that actually I think are hidden from you in my fancy new stream UI, but there's lots of them. So that's sort of like there's a lot of options if you want to do digital drawing and you know practice and do stuff that doesn't require a huge financial investment.
Yeah, I know some of our Open Squish designers have mentioned that they use Fire Alpaca.
Fire Alpaca. Cool.
And that is free, I believe. And then there are some cheaper options, cheaper than Photoshop, which is what we use. But Paint Tool Sai, I have heard things about.
Paint Tool Sai is a classic.
So those are all worth checking out.
And if you ever have any questions about digital drawing, any of you, that is another thing that I can help with, because I spend 90% of my life in Photoshop, so I can do my best. Oh, also, man behind the iron door. There isn't actually a hole in this mug. It's just full of holes so that you can stick things to it. So it's not like a magic. It's not really magic. It just maybe looks like it's magic.
Here's magic-like.
There are also holes, like Lego holes in the bottom. And on the front of the box, which is not something that I would ever recommend, there was a person who put their mug on a complicated wheel pulley system, and it was like zooming down the table. I can't imagine any situation that would be a good idea, because a hot beverage filled mug should not be mobile, should not be able to go anywhere.
Alex, another thing, I see you're mentioning that you normally work on your phone on Photoshop Sketch and Draw. If you do want to make it your career, I would definitely suggest starting to learn to work with a tablet. That's what we use, and that helps you to really get those, to emulate the thick and thin lines that you can get with practical, real traditional inking. So yeah, we all use tablets here.
Even if you have like a, an iPad or a Nexus tablet or something, Wacom, the company that uses that makes professional tablets, has styluses that have pressure sensitivity. So you can just sort of like make your regular iPad into a drawing device if you're still getting a feel for what you like to do. Those are called the bamboo styluses, I believe. Floofs.
Charles in the background.
I didn't know what was
essential
in the
slowly
picture.
Slowly mug into the screen.
Charles, you're right there. That's Charles. Say hello, everyone.
Hi, how you doing?
Charles, tell a joke.
Yeah, tell a joke.
I'm putting you on the
spot. Tell a joke.
I'm putting you on the spot.
I need to run over to my computer and buy a whole bunch of Wacom stock after that endorsement. Wacom, yeah, use it if you want to work.
Yeah, not a sponsored stream.
You can't put me on the spot.
I'm putting you on the spot. You should have been prepared for this when you stepped into my shot.
All of my jokes have a constituency that they offend.
That's true. Charles is an offensive man.
Yeah, I'm a regular. I'm like Lenny Bruce with an Excel spreadsheet.
Shoo! Right over my head.
Lenny Bruce's?
No.
Oh.
We're not that much older than you, Pat.
Yeah, we are.
Lenny Apparently. Bruce? Okay. Andrew Dice Clay?
No.
It's like a tactless Lenny Bruce.
None of those words have any meaning for me. I'm sorry. I'm letting you all down.
It's a fluffy doggo.
Yeah, but on the other hand, look at how handsome this dog is.
It's a handsome doggo. I'm writing the product description for the Samoyed now. We did let people know that it is in fact coming out.
Yep.
Yes.
If you want to.
So I'm writing the product description.
Yes, it's right here in my lap.
that's the product.
If you want to make this a hot dog doggo, then.
A what doggo?
Hot doggo.
Oh.
Boop.
So are those like.
They're just handsome sparkles. He's very handsome.
He's handsome and drooling.
Okay, let's make a comic. Let's
you
make a
comic.
Use my comic idea? Not for this one, though. I said I'm gonna put Jenna on it. Jenna, you have an incoming assignment if you're out there.
Oh, is Jenna watching? Hi, Jenna.
She pops on and off. Sad Pear says hello, Charles.
Who?
Sad Pear.
Oh, Sad Pear. Hi.
Yeah.
Why are you sad? Are you prickly pear?
Alex, I don't know if they work on an iPad Mini 2, but you should be able to look it up on the compatibility. I can try and get. I'll try and find a link for you and post it in the chat before I log off, so that you can get the right track.
Yeah.
Get on the right track.
Take a look and see what I can find.
I compulsively stalk all of the newfangled drawing tech. Not that I buy any of it, but I just like to know. All right, so.
Stylus works with iPad Mini 1, 2, 3, iPad 3 and 4, and iPad Air 1.
Oh,
I will
all right.
Drop the link in the comments right now.
Highly recommended.
Pretty neat.
I had an idea for this earlier, because I don't know if you've all seen that video of the time lapse of someone brushing their Samoyed, and the amount of fur that's brushed out of this puppy creates an entirely new dog-sized pile. So that's where I'm going with this.
Jay, I see your question here about the most complicated design that we've done that wasn't benched. I'm thinking about it right now.
Ooh, the most complicated design that
wasn't
benched.
That we were able to achieve.
Okay, well, that's.
Fear.
I guess that excludes ones that we're currently working on.
Yeah, Golden Tigers.
That's pretty complicated.
Golden Tiger holds the record for the most.
Cerberus is pretty.
On a squishable.
Yeah.
Golden Tiger is. Okay.
Fortune Cat's pretty complex.
Fortune Cat is pretty complex. Golden Tiger is pretty complex. I have a feeling that the Fairy Dragon, which is currently in process, is
going to be
a nightmare of complexity.
Yeah, so we definitely want to make it, but we've yet to see the first prototype on the Fairy Griffin, and it is...
we've been having some struggles.
Yeah, so we will see how that one turns out, but fingers crossed, because it's such a cute design.
That haunch is too big, pet. Oh, do we have a pug here?
Oh, we should, yes. Let me take a look. Let's see.
We do. Yeah, no problem, Jay. It's interesting because sometimes designs that you wouldn't expect to have 1 million billion pieces end up having 1 million billion pieces.
Pug.
Pug. Zoop. Big pug.
Also with a little fluffy tail. We have these in a mini size as well. I don't know if they're in stock or not, but...
But there he is.
There he is.
Nonetheless.
I think they are, yeah.
They probably are. All right, I have my model sitting on the chair next to me now.
Someone asked about the octopus squishable.
Yes.
The original is actually right here.
He's in stock.
And he is in stock, and Zoe actually designed this guy back in the day. This is one of our originals.
Oh yeah.
And we have we also have a happy octopus. We have a prism octopus that's based on this guy. And we may or may not have something else in the works.
just mysterious pointing with an octopus.
I'm not going to tell you any more than that. But
the octopus is being
OG
very mysterious.
Is our wonderful Zoe.
Very mysterious. How mysterious? So mysterious. Octopi are very mysterious.
Also, they're not actually octopi.
Oh, is it octopuses?
It is actually more grammatically correct that way.
Really?
It is not a Latin word, so actually octopi doesn't really make sense.
Well, it sounds fancier.
Octopodes. Actually is a real thing. Octopuses is technically the real right way in English.
All right, duly noted. Every day is a school day.
That's right. I just learned this the other day. That is why I know that.
Yeah, don't get on a high horse with me. Oh no, it's crashing.
No.
Why?
No.
All right. I apologize, everyone.
Oh my gosh, my Siri's talking to itself again.
You just get a glimpse of my desktop background now.
Mm-hmm.
And we are just going to go straight back to a regular display. Whoa! That's better. Bing! I'm back. And we're back. One day, I'll be able to have a fancy user interface throughout the entire stream, but today is obviously not that day. Here we go. Good as new. See, now you can see my abundance of tool presets. Woo! Yeah, Photoshop is apparently very, very temperamental because, it's susceptible to Cthulhu's madness. Who isn't? But I guess Samoyeds are very furry and prone to allergies, so. Whatever. Oh, my foot got lost.
Oh.
Gotta redraw this foot. That was a good foot, too.
Save often.
Save often. Learn from my mistakes. Mm-hmm. Photoshop can crash at any moment! Trellis, I know. It's my sin. Everyone has a special place in my heart. Absolutely not. That's a lie. I haven't used half of them. Mm-hmm. But
it's an addiction.
But I just know they're there, you know? They're there supporting me. If ever I need a watercolor brush that is not too firm and not too soft, they're there. I need to save this. Zoop. At least the little brush was still stuck in its hair. See, I try to get this so that there's a little window above my head that has another view of like the layers or the colors or something that's interesting that you people might want to take note of for your own purposes. I know I would like that, but that's not this day. Jay, yeah, I know those feels. See, no art program is stable, not even Photoshop. Oh, Alex, that's actually a very interesting point, working with people. We actually love doing licensing and working with people that have, like, you know, existing characters, but it's really up to them. We, can't just make, like, a My Little Pony character and hope that, you know, whoever makes My Little Pony is okay with it. It'd have to be a real thing that they ask us to do. So if you want something like that, just the best thing to do is to get people to let the creators know that we exist, because I don't think a whole lot of people in the toy world know that they can get little balls of love designed by us or whoever.
The more people that know about us, the more companies that know about us, the better chance that we would potentially have for collaboration with those types of companies.
The good thing about getting a real squishable Samoyed is that it won't shed all over your house. and create doppelgangers of itself. Mm-hmm. Trill House? I'm glad.
So much love. Or maybe he's saying that that looks like a minimal.
Oh, it might.
That actually is probably what they are trying to say.
Oh, thank you, Alex. Derpy.
Okay, Thrill House was referring to a comment earlier about Squishables having lots of love.
Aww.
Then, like the minimals. Understood, yes.
Now we understand.
Sorry.
We're a little slow on the the uptake.
It's definitely a Monday.
This is very silly. Who knows which one is the real doggo? Mm-hmm. I certainly don't.
Mystery.
It's still a mystery. Always name your layers, folks. Because you might know where all the layers are right now, but then in 2 days you go back, open up Photoshop document, and there's 50 layers, and none of them are labeled, and they're all out of order. And then your life becomes much worse. See, this is the other problem with having a million presets. I don't know which one I want to use. That was cute. Have it. Mm-hmm. Eyes are the worst. You know, you think I draw a lot of circles all day. You'd think that it would get easier to draw circles. It really doesn't. They're always hard.
So hard.
They are always hard.
I'd rather draw a straight line than a circle.
Yeah.
They're both difficult, but circles are particularly hard.
Yeah, right? You gotta try and make the eyes match, but the tiniest fraction of asymmetry is so unbelievably obvious. You're like, why? Why do this? Get his hairbrush in there. Is this the kind of brush you use to comb dogs? I don't know.
Sure. There's all kinds of brushes. I like that one.
Ooh, a chinchilla squishable.
Oh, so cute.
Chinchillas are adorable.
I was watching a TV show with a chinchilla this weekend. I was just losing it. They were so cute. With the best tails.
They have amazing tails. They also are very soft, so they would mm-hmm. fit right in. All right, I feel validated, Jay. Thank you. Feel validated. Those floofs are not the best floofs. The art of floofing. It's going to be the title of my memoir. I think it's very important when you're drawing a cartoon of a squishable to give them silly hands. Mm-hmm. So they usually have just like little nubs. But why not? You're just drawing them. Who cares? Give them little weird hands. Sort of like in the same way that last week, if anyone was watching, saying how like it's different drawing a prototype drawing of a squishable because it has to be very clean lines, very descriptive, very proper in three dimensions. When you're just drawing for fun, you can make them look cute in ways that would not be able to be made into a plush for any of our open squish artists out there.
You're not worrying here about where things are fitting and what seams need to be where and what needs to be coming from where. This is just whatever you want to make it when you're drawing a comic.
Exactly. I know I'm going to jinx it, but we have not had a whole lot of sirens today either. Feel
it's
blessed.
It's been unusually quiet.
I think we said that the same thing last week.
Yes.
And then immediately 50 sirens started blaring.
Yes.
So I might have doomed us all. Doomed the stream. Floofy tail. I'm sorry, you all had to hear that.
Sad Pear lives near a fire department substation, and there are always sirens.
Oh, Sad Pear.
I know how that is. I live next to a hospital, so sirens all the time.
Yeah, every 5 minutes.
Almost to the point where I don't really hear them anymore.
This is a little bit creepy, but whatever.
Sort of like Pigpen from Peanuts.
It is like Pigpen.
An aura of like
an
dust
aura.
All around.
Yeah, little sculpture of discarded hair. That is really making it. I'm really selling it. You're drag racing and train tooting? That is so many sounds.
Drag racing, wow.
Who drag races? Is it like...
Haven't you ever seen Fast and the Furious, Pat?
Oh, I have actually.
It's hard to miss
when there are eight Fast and the Furious movies.
True.
There's another one coming out. Yes. Fate of the Furious, and it has the best movie poster I've ever seen.
And then there's RuPaul.
And then there's RuPaul.
RuPaul Drag Race.
Yeah, it's true.
I love that.
Oh, that's okay, Jay. I won't hold you to any typing standards that you cannot reach.
His little face cracks me up.
His little horrific face.
It's great. It's like a cross between like a dust bunny and a... voodoo doll.
It might be a little of both.
Yeah.
Who's to say? Who is to say? I feel like if a gust of wind were to blow across the scene, hypothetically, the entirety of the fur dog would just like tumbleweed out of frame.
Raccoon noises.
The raccoon noises. Man, everyone's hearing some weird stuff.
Yeah.
Their domicile. So it's not just us. I feel less bad about...
Yes, we're all in good company here.
Because it is too nice to not have the windows open, and it is very loud. Hey, Caretoons.
Hello.
How's it going?
Welcome.
Thanks for joining us.
We're talking about sirens and raccoons screaming and drawing some fluffy dogs.
What could be better, right?
Not much.
I don't think anything could be better. Fluffy dogs. Mm-hmm. Raccoon screaming. You know, all in a day. Oh, thank you, Caretoons. This is the Squishable Samoyed that we're drawing, which is a real thing that is coming out this week. Here he is. Yeah, typical Monday. I was going to draw little tassels on this rug, but I have decided that is too many tassels to draw, so. So sue me. It's real! It's a real thing! We also have a smaller one, a limited edition one, that you can get.
That sold out. Let me find out.
I don't think so. Last time I checked, there was still a handful left.
Okay. Yeah, it is. Still in stock.
Yes, a doggo without the excess shed. And Caretoons, this is one of my 50 billion tool presets. I believe I got this one. This is the rough inker from Kyle T. Webster's ink set.
Oh, I like that one.
Yeah, one. It's really nice. It has a nice little, like, edge to it, a little toothy. Zooming in on this horrible face. Okay, let's color this. And I kind of cheated. Oh, my chair's breaking. I kind of cheated because Samoyeds are white dogs, so it's sort of the least amount of work possible. Let's see. See, now, this is where my million tools come in handy. Mm-hmm. I have one in particular that I really like. Try to find. Here it is. Although, with me streaming, it's going very slowly.
Oh, no.
Whee! Oh boy. It's okay. You work with what you got. Woo, woo. I'm gonna crash Photoshop again. I am making a bet. Yeah, the lag. All right, that brush is
Yes,
done.
That pair's reminding you to do click save.
Oh, thank
click
you.
Save.
Oh, y'all got my back. Yeah, fast color job and then destroys my computer. It doesn't help that I made that brush way bigger than it was supposed to be, so it's really my fault. Yes, yeah, so the peril of any art stream, that is very well put. Very well put. Very ghostly fluff ball. So ghostly. Oh, look at those guys. So cute. And oh, yeah, this is gonna be a laggy day. I'm gonna be doing a lot of saving. Should we make this rug? I don't know if any of you are familiar with clipping masks, but they're the best thing ever invented by anyone. Another really fun thing that I like to do that sort of makes a line drawing look slightly fancier than it actually is going in and changing the color of the lines by using the color overlay effect. Damn. Instant fancy illustration. But you didn't hear it from me. Hot tips. Eventually, you can just not even have a fancy brush and just go in with a basic brush. Actually, Rachel, who was here last week, does that. She does not use any fancy brushes.
She is crazy.
She doesn't use any textures. She just goes in with the basic round brush with a pen pressure opacity and goes to town and makes crazy paintings with them.
It's pretty impressive.
It is very impressive. I don't know how she does it. Other than with a lot of patience.
And practice.
She does it pretty quick, too.
Yeah. Yes, she does.
A round little iceberg in the ocean. It is very oceany. I might have gone a little bit overboard with this blue. Yeah, overboard. Get it? Boo. Charles should be out here for that one.
That's very Charles-like.
Yeah, that is slightly more believable. Well, clearly Photoshop is no exception, Alex. I mean, Jay. Apologies. Glad you're back. Is your stream slightly less laggy, or is that going on with everyone? Where did I put the yellow? Oh. Whatever. I'm not even going to worry about it. Well, I'll have to check into what is doing that. I know our Samoyed's ears are not pink, but this needs a little bit of color, so I'm breaking all the rules. Every rule into the trash. Oh, sorry, Alex, I did not even see that question. How many layers per drawing? Very much depends on the drawing. I will be lazy and do a drawing in 2 or 3 layers, or I will create a horrible nightmare of 100 layers. And each one is for something very specific. Usually I try and keep it concise though, or use a lot of folders because no one wants to sift through that many layers. But I wasn't, when I was doing really big projects for school, I would use like a really big printer to print them on. I would crash computers all the time, every day. This one, it's probably gonna cap out. There's usually like a sketch, and then some ink, and then maybe a couple layers for color, and that's about it. I also try and keep shading off of layers with other colors, but in this case I'm ignoring that rule because it's one of those situations where I want to be as concise as possible. Yeah, that's probably a pretty good size, Alex. Like four layers, you get what you need done. It's a good place to start, and then if you like really feel the need for additional layers, you should always just like go for it. Like, oh, I want an effect here, or I don't want to bother like this color, so I'm gonna do another layer. Because that is the advantage of doing things on the computer. I did go to an art school. I have a degree in illustration, whatever that means. Who knows what that means? Also, these dogs are just about done. Smudge Tool is your best friend when you're doing quick and dirty shading.
Caretoons is asking what the illustration is for a comic.
It was actually just sort of like a general, like, illustration practice type program, but I did do a comic. And it was a very difficult and very rewarding project, because any of you who makes comics knows they are a time sink. You could spend literally forever making a comic.
I think they're asking about this, actually. But
oh, what is this illustration for? Well, I just need to learn how to read. This is...
or I need to know how to tell you correctly.
No, this is just sort of... this is just for a little, like, I mean, I guess it's not really a comic because it's not layered, or not paneled, but anything can be a comic.
It's like a one-panel comic.
It's like a one-panel comic.
Yeah.
Just for fun.
A little storytelling.
No pressure. No pressure.
Is Charles still snooping around in the back?
Charles, stop what snooping.
What are you doing back there?
Yeah, just for funsies. Just to celebrate the release of the Samoyed plushie. I think that's a good, as good a reason as any. Certainly good enough for me. Someone saw you snooping.
Snoopy Charles was snooping around.
Hidely hodly there, Twitcherinos.
Ooh, that is a good quote. Can someone write that down? Hidely hodly diddly doodly. Charles Flanders. and yes, Alex, there is definitely a blend tool in Photoshop. It's a little bit tricky. Charles. Charles making a mess. On rough days, more like every day. More like every day.
Yeah, we actually have a pile of them in the vault, which is in here. Where Charles has been coming in and out. In the vault, it is full of prototypes, and sometimes we sit in them when we have meetings.
Sometimes we sit in them.
Sirens, Pat.
Sirens.
See, we didn't even notice.
Yeah, we don't even hear them anymore. We're not sorry.
It's because we're doing all the crying.
Mm-hmm.
Charles is off to do a crime. Have fun at your crime, Charles.
Okay, no problem. I'm thinking tampering with the mail, maybe?
Ooh.
Or like, what's another good crime?
What is another good crime?
You know, in Baltimore, it's illegal to bring a lion into a movie theater.
Are you going to go bring a lion into a movie theater in Baltimore?
I think I am.
You should. I'd like to see that.
You're both from Jersey. Is there anywhere in between New York and Baltimore where you can get a lion?
A lion?
Probably. You could go to Big Earl's Lion Emporium.
Oh, yeah. That's the best place for it, for sure.
Really?
It's the best place for it.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to think Short Hills Mall.
Short Hills Mall?
Oh,
yeah, but those are really expensive.
Yeah. They're not cheap there.
Yeah, you're not a lion.
Whoa.
All right, with that.
And with that.
Okay, with that, Charles out.
He is going to quit while he's ahead with that one.
I'm way behind.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Samoyed and Austin description are in.
Perfect, thank you.
All right, comic number one. Yeah, Tiger is totally fine.
Care to move to the vault is our conference room. And it doesn't actually lock.
And general
anymore.
Storage
it
area.
Used to.
It used to lock.
Now we have very important meetings there.
Very important.
Very businessy.
Business. Business. All right, next. What should the Samoyed be doing next? Maybe he should be hanging out with another dog.
Another dog that might be released this week as well?
Ooh.
What do you think about that?
What do I think about that? I think that's great.
Good night, guys.
Good night, Aaron.
See you tomorrow.
Hasta mañana. Have a good night.
And then there were two.
Round two.
Sam, do you want to turn that light on over there?
Yeah, it is a little dark.
It's a little dark in here.
A little dark in here.
I mean, it may not be very apparent on the screen, but...
That didn't do much, did it?
No.
But
it did something.
Turn back here. It's metal.
It did something. All right, what kind of dog should be the Samoyed's best friend? Cast your votes now!
Is that better?
That is so much better. Oh my god.
What about... Here, let's give them some options.
Cast your votes now!
We have... I'm gonna bring over three options.
Okay, three options. Okay, well, we already got a vote for the Husky.
Okay.
We got Basset Hound. We don't have a Basset Hound, sorry. Beagle. The saddest dog. Oh my god, yeah, Basset Hounds are the saddest dog. We got Boston Terrier. Right now they're just orbs.
Where is the Husky? Pug. What dog pug
do? Alright, we got Husky.
Husky Pug at Boston.
Pug. Or
I'm trying to see if I can find
Boston Terrier. Ba na 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 na.
Another guy that's coming out also this week. Squishable Boston Terrier. So he's another new guy. We have Corgi. We also have a Husky. We could do the Husky. I just can't find one. But we have them too.
Corgo.
Yeah. So let us know.
Let us know in the comments below. Oh, hey, Jenna. You missed your shout out earlier. You got a shout out and you're not getting another one.
Jenna, Jenna's too busy working on her thesis.
Yeah,
she's working on an amazing, amazing cartoon right now.
Okay.
Super good. And I'm really excited. I still haven't watched the trailer yet, but I'm going to. Very soon.
You're never going to know, Jenna.
Yeah, sorry.
It's too late.
Too late.
All right, so we got a Boston Pugsky. That is maybe the least helpful. Jay, thank you for nothing.
Thanks for combining them all into one.
We got a Corgo. We got Pug, Husky Pug.
Huskies and Samoyeds can bond over their excitement. Sad pair.
That is true.
They definitely have the most in common.
I mean, yeah, corgis floof a lot. Okay, my executive decision. Why?
Of course.
Is corgi because I love drawing corgis. Thanks. Thanks, everyone. Please don't hate me. Executive decision made. But it was influenced by the masses. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, Team Pat.
Nope, Alex, that is just New York.
Hello, Katie Bach.
Oh, I know who that is. Hi, Mom.
Floral House, thank you for being on my team. Also, our building is not on fire, but it sounds like that fire engine was right outside our window, even though we're 18 floors up.
You never know.
Hey, Katie. Yes, Throw House, you are right. Someone does have to be on my team. Sam.
I'm on your team.
We're rivals. Yeah. Hour one is always, it's quiet, too quiet. And then you realize that you can never be too quiet.
It's true.
Also, advantage of the corgi is that I don't really need to look at one to draw it, because I know how to draw a corgi at this point. Oh, they're best friends.
Cute.
Yeah, it's certainly an experience, Alex. You gotta get used to a lot of stuff.
Sure.
But, it's New York.
Oh, yes, Alex, I remember the donut corgi dog.
Oh, yeah! Oh my gosh. I can't believe that it's been you the whole time! We know you.
Yeah. I'm drawing to a name.
it's infectious. I don't know if you've all noticed, but I love drawing little hairdos on these dogs. It's my favorite thing in the world. And I don't know why I want this, but I want the Samoyed to be holding a mug of cocoa.
It's cozy.
And guess what? It's my drawing. I get to do whatever I want.
It's your world.
Oh, cartoons. I'm so glad that you are enjoy our horrible banter and shrieking sirens instead of hating it. That makes me happy. And that's, now this is whipped cream, not poo. It's impossible to draw whipped cream without making it look like poo.
Completely impossible.
Of this, I'm certain.
How many times did we draw whipped cream or something of the sort in the coloring book?
Yeah. So
just knowing that it was going to be colored brown by someone.
So Sam and I, last summer, worked on a coloring book. We can link to it. It is maybe the most demanding thing I've ever done. Oh, here it is.
Here it is.
Shameless plug.
Shameless plug. We made a book. It's on Amazon.
Yep.
And our website, too.
I don't care. Buy it.
I'm going to try and find some
cream. Find some whipped cream that looks like poo.
There's a lot of that.
If you get it, you can find a page with whipped cream and color it like poo, and there's nothing that I can do about it.
Nope, there's nothing.
I don't know why that would be a draw, but here it is. That is like more like a cat than a Samoyed.
Soft serve tops have the same issue, don't they?
Yep, soft serve tops, whipped cream. Ugh, filthy. It's all just poop.
Dirty, dirty,
just poop jokes.
All poop jokes. All
this day. Is why you came on to the Squishable live stream.
Yeah, we're very professional.
We're professional.
Oh, here's one on top of a pie.
Ooh. See it? That's poop. That's poop. Except it's not.
Beautiful drawing nonetheless, but it is actually pumpkin pie with some whipped cream on top.
Oh, thank you for your endorsement, sad pear. It means a lot to us. Spooky Jay, that is real life. Those Jersey Gremlins are a real threat.
Yeah, sorry, cartoons. You can't see it now.
Yeah, we're just ruining things for everyone.
Is the Jersey Devil a gremlin?
No, but
it's just a
demon.
Sorts.
I'm just going to make this easy. This just straight up looks like a cat doing something wrong. Maybe it's the cheeks.
Mm. Yeah, not super dog-like.
Yeah, it does sort of look like a diamondy gemstone. I think that's my favorite thing about the corgi. The little head detail. Yeah.
Yeah.
I drew dogs before. Why is it? It's the face. The face is wrong. Isn't right. God. I Okay, I drew this doggo before. I know I can draw this doggo.
Drawn him many times.
Yeah, Trill House. It's true. Also, I keep saying Trill House. Your name is Thrill House. Your username is Thrill House. I don't know. I obviously can't read, so okay. I'm just screwing up.
Multitasking right now.
Every which way. I can't be bothered to do anything. See, I can see the doggo ghosted behind.
Ooh, there he is.
He's so handsome. Ah, too many layers.
I think the nose is too big.
You know what? Starting over. Hard reset. Bam.
Whoa.
I know. Crazy!
Man.
Ooh. Hard reset. Sometimes you do a drawing and you're not happy with it, and it's just easier to start over than it is to try and fix it. Katie, actually, I'm not very nervous with people watching me draw. I used to have a professor in school that I did. I worked for the university graphic design place, and he used to, when I did projects for him, sit right here and comment on every single thing that I did. And really, you're only nervous for the first 2 or 3 hours, and then you're just annoyed, so. Hey, Bill. Welcome. Welcome to the stream, where I'm trying to draw a dog, and instead I got a cat.
Struggle is real.
So, join me in my struggle. Okay. This one is going to have a bigger forehead, a smaller muzzle. It's going to look like a dog. It's still going to have a mug of cocoa.
Jenna.
Jenna, this makes me happy. For those of you that don't know, I love birds. I love all birds. And I infect those around me with a love of birds.
And Jenna is taking a bird watching class in school, which is very interesting. I didn't even know that existed, and I'm jealous.
I feel like she's not taking a bird watching class. She might have just literally seen birds while she was in class.
No, she's taking a class.
You're taking a class?
Yes.
Jenna, where are you taking a bird watching class? And why didn't you tell me?
We are technically students now.
This is my bird. I designed him, and he is my child. He is my baby. Yes, we all have the same humor, and we need to stick together. Jenna, I'm so jealous. Why do you do this to me? In my time of need. Which is to say, all the time, I am in need of birds.
Alex, what is this workout game where you can play as a chicken?
I also love chickens.
I also want to play this workout game as you can be a chicken.
Yeah, you can be a chicken.
That's pretty cool.
Become the chicken! Struggle is real. I'm also trying to not be too zoomed in because that's not as interesting, but I might just need to abandon that. Jenna, this message got filtered through the spam and I had to approve it. Amazing. Jay, I support you and your endeavors. And your chicken-based endeavors.
Oh, the game is We Fit You. I think I have We Fit.
Oh yeah, is it, oh, that must be, because I had the original We Fit back in the day.
Yeah, that's the one I'm thinking of.
It must be a sequel, right? It must be a sequel. Okay, I think this looks more like a Samoyed.
Yeah.
Right? This is kind of a doggo, not a catto.
Definitely doggo.
Okay, the big tail will help. I'm gonna get his tail in here ASAP. And have it not look like a snail shell. God, I am on the struggle bus today. Adorable. Gatto. Mm-hmm. Wonder if they're gonna have a Wii Fit or a Switch Fit for their new console. I wonder how that would work. As promised, Coco. With poop on it. Just kidding, it's whipped cream. Ha! Got you. Honk! The best express train. So let's take a second and talk about the April Fool's joke.
Yeah, let's.
But yes, I do need Breath of the Wild also. So for those of you that did not see, which is I'm assuming, you know, at least a few of you, on Saturday for April Fool's, we posted a new line, a joke called Squishable Minimals. And through the magic of the internet, a lot of people saw it, and a lot of people said that they wanted it. For real. And it was a joke that was a totally viable, like, it's not an astronomical feat. We could definitely do it, and in fact, we are going to do it. And they're up for pre-order right now.
We
have
backers.
We have two sizes of Squishable Minimals up for pre-order, and if 100 people pre-order them, one of them, or both of them, then we will make it. This is crazy to me. They are literally just spheres. I mean, they're very attractive, soft spheres.
Very soft.
But what do you guys think? Do you have any opinions on this? Because this is mind-blowing to me. I guess it shouldn't be super surprising because we do have incredibly soft, squishy things. But
that's true.
I guess
I'll post this again for anybody who's just hopping in on the conversation.
Hey, Clucky. Yeah, that's the internet for you, right? We live in a crazy, insane time. I think it's pretty crazy. That being said, I am sort of excited to see what happens.
Yeah. This is very non-intentional, but
unintentional, but potentially.
If you guys
funny.
Like it, we will make it happen for sure.
Aesthetic. Yeah, everyone says that they look like tribbles, right? I've not actually seen the episode of Star Trek from which tribbles hail from.
Right, but we know all about them.
But I know exactly what they are. Yeah, when the jokes become real. And I resized the Samoyed, and now I have totally ruined this stupid intersection of doggo. The doggo intersection. Mm-hmm. know not of tribbles? It's true. We're heathens. I know. I need to get on board and get with that William Shatner episode because he is amazing.
He is.
All I can think about when I think about the William Shatner, Captain Kirk, is that fight scene that went viral a while ago, where it is William Shatner fighting like a weird space lizard thing, and it is the most hilariously choreographed fight ever. I think about that a lot. Yeah, they're so funny, right? I really need to revisit it. I recently started watching Mystery Science Theater again.
Ooh.
They hold up.
Yeah.
Some of the cultural references are a little bit lost in translation, but they have their jokes land. It is so impressive. You gotta keep up, Alex. we're bouncing from subject to subject at lightning speed.
Are they doing a reboot of Mystery Science Theater?
I think they are. I think they're making new episodes.
This month, I think.
Really? Is it this month?
I think so.
Because those guys still, make content. Like they do riff tracks.
Let me see.
And riff tracks are funny. All right. I don't want to get too crazy with the sketch. Oh, thanks, Katie. Yeah, Bill, have you watched, I watched Werewolf and Zombie Nightmare. I think they're the last two episodes of season one. They are phenomenal. They're phenomenal. Adam West is in one of them. It's amazing.
Mystery Science Theater 3000 reboot hits Netflix on April 14th.
April 14th? That's so close to now. I gotta keep an eye out for that. Once again, this is not a sponsored stream.
Yes, right. We're just dropping names left and right.
We're just name dropping. Nope. Content. Ah, this is cute. This is a cute start off point.
Yeah.
Alright, we did A rough inker.
Rough.
A rough inker. Hoi, 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 hoi. Charles would be proud
of
you.
Thank you.
A rough inker. Now we gotta do something else. Yeah, put it on your lifts, Bill. Yeah, so Alex, this is like what I would consider the planning stage. Like, okay, you got a sketch, you keep it loose, you don't like put too much time and energy into it. Like before when I erased the original Samoyed drawing, I didn't feel too bad about it because, you know, it just, you know, it's whatever. It's a sketch. It's supposed to be a plan. And then you go back, and then I'll do precisely what I'm about to do and go back. Turn down the opacity of the sketch, and then usually I go over it in black just for tradition's sake. You can change the colors of the lines afterwards, but that's how I do it. That's a good brush. I like the tech pen brushes. I'm gonna use this brush. you like that nice little scribble? That gross scribble? Yay. Oh, pod people? Okay, I'll put that on my list. Good. This is good. This is a good relationship we got here. Boop. It's not big enough. Yeah, absolutely. The best way to get better at drawing is to just try new stuff all the time. this is clearly my amazing ability to draw ovals at work here. Also, Rachel tells me that she doesn't know anyone else that uses the radial menu for these tablets. I don't believe her. I love my little shortcuts. To Bill, to everyone, whatever. Caretoons. So the hotkey, this is maybe the best thing that I've ever learned in my life. The hotkey for rotating the canvas in Photoshop is R. And if you hold down the R key, if you press and hold the R key and then use the mouse or your stylus to rotate the canvas and then release the R key, your tool will snap back to the one that you had on originally. So if I'm like drawing with a brush and I hit and hold R and then rotate my canvas and then release R, it'll go back to the brush immediately. It is so handy, and it's really nice when you're doing like a sort of more finished lines like this, when you know you have a tablet and some angles are really hard to nail, spinning the canvas around to get it to be more comfortable makes it easier to get really smooth lines. If you guys are interested, and let me know, because this is a thing that I would love to do. I can make a stream specifically for like tips and tricks about Photoshop. I've been using Photoshop and this current version for quite a number of years, and have plenty to work from in terms of like weird and stupid things that no one ever tells you. So if that's something that you're interested in, let me know, and I'm happy to do it. What? Alex, so in terms of line weight, I find it's very nice to vary line weight. In my own illustrations, I tend to start with thick lines, which is to say I'll pick an arbitrary line weight and do that, and then do a second pass for details with smaller, finer lines. For stuff that I do here, especially like these comics, I generally just use one size and have them vary slightly so that it has like a really kind of crisp, cartoony feel to it. That's, again, it's just all about what you want to experiment with. Oh, cool. Yeah, I think that's the thing that I will definitely plan and announce on Twitch and on Facebook, so if you guys are interested in seeing that, we'll do it! Also, Killer Shrews sounds amazing, and I love watching old movies and laughing at them, so I'll put that on my list as well. Lots of new movies for Pat on this stream. I'm into it. Yeah, it occurs to me that you guys tune in to watch me draw and talk about squishables, but I can actually explain what I'm doing if you'd like, so. I was just talking about a potential, you know, how-to stream.
Yes.
In Photoshop, Sam.
I think that would be fantastic.
Yes. I think, actually, Bill, that is what we're probably going to be doing next week. So we stream on Twitch on Mondays, and actually, if you want to see a prototype to, or a start to finish, you know, design drawing to prototype thing, actually on Wednesday, on our Facebook, the Squishable Facebook, we're going to be doing prototype drawing also. So there'll be two shows for you to tune into if you want. The previous stream, actually, on Twitch that is still archived, I believe, I walked through the first steps in a squishable skeleton design, which is actually, I think we're going to probably submit that at some point to be made, which I can do, like, I'll follow up with and show you the final
dropping in the in process page, which shows a lot of our concept drawings, and you can follow along on that page, and we'll update it with what some of the prototypes look like, and once we approve it, we'll approve it on there, and eventually we'll go to either pre-order or will be sold on our site, if we decide to do it. We do occasionally bench something if it's not quite working out.
Yeah, we try a lot of, we prototype a lot of things, and usually we can nail it pretty good. Sometimes a concept is really good in theory, and then in practice it turns out to be really weird.
Yeah, not everything translates quite well.
Oh, cool. I'm looking forward to checking out your stuff, Bill. It's interesting doing drawings for production and drawings for cartoons or illustrations, because for actually producing physical toys, you have to be a lot more descriptive with clean lines and almost measured accuracy and multiple angles. So it's certainly at least a little bit less fun, because you know I wouldn't be putting little cute details and floofs on this corgi, or you know, like a face that only kind of works in the drawing. You have to be like, okay, this is what embroidery looks like, this is where certain pieces fit together, that kind of thing. So it is actually pretty different. Something to get used to. Little toesies. Little toesies. I love little toe beans. I don't know if that's what you call them for dogs. That's what you call them for cats, but. Oh no. I don't know if it's Twitch or our internet. Because a couple people have been saying that the stream has been a little laggy. Have you seen anything, Sam?
No, it seems to be working okay for me.
Okay.
Our network is actually, for once, not going super slow.
I will look into that, because I do have it set so that I can see your comments faster. It's like a beta that Twitch is doing, but I might just turn that off if people are having trouble with lag, because I think it's a little bit more taxing on the stream. So that is good to know. Aw, Jay. I believe that you can make it work. Okay, well, even still, I'll try and make sure that I'm not putting any undue pressure on the servers or whatever.
This is still all a new process for us.
But if you do have any trouble with the stream, I would just recommend refreshing the page, because chances are it will help. As crazy as that sounds, I'm always amazed whenever I have trouble with a web page or my computer, just turning it off and on again actually does help. It's not just like a joke. You're like, what did I even do? Why is this working? You're back! Nice. Ooh. Zoop. So we're in the last 15 minutes, guys. These drawings took longer than I thought. But like I alluded to before, we are of course on Twitch every Monday. But we're also this Wednesday going to be live on Facebook. in the evening because we are masochists who don't have lives. So I can post, I'll post a link in our updates section on the channel about where you can find our Facebook stream if you're interested. That'll be from 6 to 8, so a little bit later, for those of you that have a different schedule. Yeah, Bill, you're totally right. Simplified designs definitely work best for plush, and adding on, you know, like very intentional detail, because you don't, you have to keep in mind, you know, certain textures, certain patterns can't really translate into plush, at least our plush that have like this really nice shaggy fur that's super soft. So when, at least when we make plush, we have to make sure that, you know, the details are within reason, the construction is super solid, you know, we don't want anything falling apart. So yeah, it's definitely a process, but that's why prototypes exist, so that we can go through and make sure that everything is picture perfect. This corgi is so excited. So photogenic. Yes, Alex, Monday streams are 5 to 7 p.m. Eastern time. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Yes, Bill, we do a lot of custom work too. So if you ever are looking, I work with a lot of people on custom plushes every day.
Yeah, we actually have made a lot of plush for webcomics and cartoons and anyone that has, you know, like a really, a character that's easily translatable, we will work with, you know, individually to make sure that it is perfect. Yeah, custom plushes. Unfortunately, only available in very large quantities.
Yes, I wish that we could do unique one-offs, but if you do want a custom, our minimum order is 1,000. So.
Yeah, you need to want 1,000 of them, yes. Unfortunately. Which is a little bit prohibitive for the average person. Because I know I would love to be able to make, you know, like one-off puppies. But it's just not in the cards for us. We're a little too small. Ooh, spooky. I love spooky plush. Jenna, we all need 1,000 bees. That is not unique to you.
Yeah, Bill, keep us in mind. We've done some really, really cool custom work. It's one of my favorite things to do. So, definitely hit us up.
Hit us up. The bees! Covered in bees! Mm-hmm. All right, so it looks like we're probably only going to have time for me to do lines for this little one panel. But I will definitely finish this week and post out what the end result will be. And Bill, yeah, I totally will. That sounds super awesome.
Yeah.
Sounds super duper awesome, actually. I'm always amazed by the incredibly talented people that are here. Got whipped cream on his nose. Oh, we're happy that you log on with us, Jay. It's so funny. Sam and I always joke, especially the people that do submit drawings to us outside of Twitch, that we're like, we kind of feel like we know you.
Yes.
So it's nice to actually you know, have some
interaction.
Direct interaction,
yeah.
That isn't just just gushing over images. You too, Alex. It's like, ooh, look at these drawings. You can only get so many drawings before you're like, I know that guy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when you start to recognize people's styles, you know who it is before you even see the name. It's lovely out still.
It is lovely out. But I think we are going to be wrapping up soon. Look at this little, this definitely looks like a dog. Okay, I feel way better. I was so frustrated. Definitely Doggo. All right, here's flip. See, that's why I love the rotate tool, because if you are having trouble making that weird curve that you shouldn't be making at that angle, then you don't need to. Magic. Technology. This is the part of the stream where I start gushing over how awesome it is that you guys join us every week, or sometimes, or just today, or whatever, because I love hanging out and drawing with you guys. So thanks for chatting and making this way less awkward than me just talking to myself in the void for 2 hours, because that's what I would have to do if if no one used the chat. So thank you guys again. I think it's awesome, and I'm glad that we have some repeat customers and some new faces, and it's just a fun time. I greatly enjoy streaming, so. Wanted to have a little floof haircut. Style and cuts. Style and cuts.
Fresh cuts.
Fresh cuts. I'm just gonna I'll finish thinking of this guy. Because it would be a sin to leave him only partially
footless.
Completed. Footless. Footless! Although I am getting progressively sloppier as the night goes on, so better quit while I'm ahead. Always give your hand a break. The thing that I have not done.
Yeah, seriously.
I don't know why the stream counter says we've been on for 3 hours.
That's weird.
It's definitely only been two.
Definitely only been
but,
two.
But whatever! Alright, well, I think that's pretty much all the inking, other than the details. That's the main ink. So that is, like, this, so now, for those of you curious about the whole, like, process, this is where I would, like, this is a good starting point for, you know, like a comic or an illustration, like, okay, you have the layout, you have the lines. Now, and what I will post later this week, I'll usually go in and change the color of the lines, which is maybe something that I'll cover if I do a Photoshop stream. Obviously block in the color, do some shading, add a background, and then, I mean, I didn't with this one, but usually there's a joke in there somewhere to make it kind of funny. But yeah, this is a solid place to start working from. And this tends to take a while. It takes a little bit longer when you're multitasking and trying to monitor the stream and chat and everything, but you get faster and faster at it, as the wizened artists in the chat will attest to. And that's that. All right. I think that's us. Thank you guys so much again. Jenna, I know you're always here in spirit. I'll see some of you maybe on Wednesday, some of you next week, and some never again, but whatever.
We'll see you all again.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.